really give you much cricket stuff. Okay, so where are Hampshire in the county championship?
Second.
Eight.
Right. We were top until this last round of fixtures. We beat North Hants with what literally would have been the final ball of the day, because we got the wicket and then 30 seconds later absolutely started pissing it down the drain. But Surrey drew with North Hants this week, so they now go 8 points clear in Hampshire.
Okay. That'll be quite soon when it's so busy.
Yeah, the next one on Tuesday.
Have we?
Yeah.
Can't get me a Preston, Billy.
Don't say no if you don't.
Could you?
Yeah. Sure. I've got your email, so I can add you to our little list.
Yeah,
give you a
please,
respect.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Can I come and sit with around you or not with you?
Yeah.
Okay, that would be really cool. Yes.
I'm not in again until Wednesday, so I'll miss the Thursday.
Yeah. I had the bloody, because I'm an old person, I had my booster jam on Thursday morning at 9:30. I had absolute shit for 2 days, so I lost 2 days this week. So, but I decided, because I've got to pack all this lot up, so that one needs to be 4.
Okay, so that'll be Matt on 4, okay?
Yeah. Right.
And I've got to give him a mic, haven't I? So yeah. Don't panic, Colin.
I got it just after.
So they play Tuesday, they're not
I guess the only days that you're not in on YouTube is make sure that the advert is.
Well, I'll wait
yeah,
to see. When are you next in?
I can rip it.
And when's the next? When's the final game?
It'd be a nice idea. Yeah, no, I could do that.
Chaps, I'm going to test fire in a sec, so don't be alarmed.
Bill was like, oh, there's not too many fours and sixes. I'm like, right. So that's 1, 2, 3.
Wow.
Right.
I'll tell you what, the price of fuel goes up anymore. We'll be having that in the winter, won't we?
I know.
Yeah.
I'll do you a special deal.
Yeah, thank you very much. Yeah.
Thank you.
looks a little bit better than it did when we first had it, all that little box to me going around the thing there. So the stream box is gone. It's now done as software right on the laptop. That's a little mini PC, which is programmed back at the studio. So when the studio receives a signal from that ISDN thing there at 2:30, it just simply transfers to us for live out to a broadcast. So, and then automatically it fades out at 3 and they hear the news, right? It fades back to us. So the only thing I've got to remember is to make sure there's noise. So I look at the clock then and I listen to it on this thing. That's the output. When I hear the end of the news, okay, so I just sort of do something. I've got a really chill jingle there, something else. I've got the Dick Giles interview about disability cricket, and also Mark Healis as well, so that's quite good. I've got the one, Kieran, your 100 thing is the only thing you say on it is that you'd rather have teeth pulled than I say, not you, that I gather you'd rather have teeth pulled and answer to go and watch a 100 game. You say, actually, no, the kids have been brilliant. I like it. It's great for them, this game, blah, 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 but I wouldn't go and see a 100 senior game.
Definitely don't want to.
That's all you say.
Basically.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Right. And I say to Wes,
food chiller.
I want you to be the sensible person in the room in case it gets a bit heated.
Right.
And it doesn't have to be.
Wes can't be sensible. He's warmed me up already by wearing it. I'm going to perch on the end here.
Hang on, let me just get these bloody things.
How much are these cost? Amazon, £2.99. They're class, aren't they? They look really sort of snazzy, they're not.
Where's your guide dog?
I'm going to mention Cabal Cricket Club today. Actually,
used to
open the bowling for them. Little medium paces.
Round the arms.
No, it was in those days, I was.
You don't want the Michael Bublé version.
I bowled 12 overs, 3 for 50. I know that's quite expensive, but I was knackered with like 45 degrees. I could definitely do it on that.
That's what we did.
Kieran,
yeah.
What you could do is you could get the batting order.
It's batting order as per card.
Okay, all right. That's very good then.
Funny thing was about YouTube adverts, I was delivering training to detectives at Temple Valley Police, and we had a TVP video about murder, really serious stuff. Describing how to pay this video. Came up as, are you 5 stone overweight? Do you want to lose weight quickly? I want to say, how embarrassing. It just had to be weight related with me.
I don't know. These are all far too bloody long anyway, so we don't know where you're going to be.
make sure you get the right one, because we share a national anthem with, I can't remember who it is now.
God, yeah.
Vatanatu or something like
don't,
that.
Don't play the German national anthem there, something like that. So, yeah.
The German national anthem.
Oh, I do. Or the
Italian national anthem is better.
That's a bouncer.
That's a real bouncy one, that is. That'll get everybody going.
I'm going to run it through just in case there's
just
some
chipmunk
version or something. Yeah.
It's, it's the Minions.
Oh.
Oh. Oh, it is.
Damn it.
That's outdated now.
We want a non-voice version,
yeah,
don't we?
Right. You are on four, okay, Matt. Oh, you joking. Would you like to hold on to that for a second, sir?
Matt?
It's playing through YouTube at the moment, but I'm going to rip it because you don't want an advert.
Yeah, that's true.
Four.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Very good afternoon to you. 1, 2.
This is Radio Charwell Sport.
Right, and we need to... Right, good afternoon, Wes. Can you hear me okay, sir? Okay, good. Can I hear you? No, that's
there
it.
We go. How about now? There we go.
That's it, yeah, yeah.
Myself now.
Good, okay, that's good then, right. So 3, 2, 1, yeah, right. Say again, Wes.
Yes, hello. Good morning, welcome to Wormsley. Beautiful Wormsley on a bit of a chilly day this morning, but the sun is out, shining nice and bright as teams are warming up in front of us.
Great. All right, 1, 2, 3, and you can't hear me. Why can't you hear me?
I can hear you.
You can hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, what have I done then? 1, 2. I'm on 1. 1, 2, 1, 2. Yeah, that's it. All right,
there we go.
Yeah, okay, right, you can hear me.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Matt will be fine. Yeah, that's good then. So, yeah. So, yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Just check.
Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10. Yes, okay, yeah, great. We're all okay. Right, fine. So, yeah, okay. What I will do is, if I put mine off, yes. So, mine's dead. Right.
testing. Check 1 2 1 2 1 2. Well, a very good morning and welcome to the beautiful Wormsley ground here in Buckinghamshire, just off, well, was historically Oxfordshire, is now Buckinghamshire, just south of High Wycombe. We're 10 minutes away from the first ball of the Wilf Bennett Trophy final between Shipton Under Wychwood and Brackley. News from the toss is that Brackley won and have elected to bat first on a slightly chilly day. The sun is out, shining nice and bright here in the Wormsley Estates. There's loads of trees all around. It's a beautiful, beautiful setting. One of the prettiest grounds, perhaps in the world even. Got Matt Bowden sat alongside to me.
Hi there.
Good morning, Matt. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you. I had an early start this morning, 6:30 to get here, to get everything set up, and everything's working amazingly.
It makes a change, isn't it? So, obviously, sad news last week. We are going to have a minute's silence a couple minutes before the game, followed by the national anthem. So we'll ring the 5-minute bell. That's going to take place 7 minutes, so in just a couple of minutes' time. And we've got the players walking around to our left, just huddling at the top of the stairs with the umpires. We've got a huge crowd in at the moment. We are expecting about 400 people to come here today. Maybe slightly early start, a bit chilly, putting a few people off perhaps, but should warm up later and should make for a beautiful, beautiful day. Umpires just having their picture taken by the one and only Kieran Bushnell. Just waiting to hear on TU News. We'll try and bring that to you as soon as we can. Shortly away from the bell being rung.
So Wes did us an amazing stat pack here. So we've got all the scores to hand and all the players' stats.
Yeah, I spent a couple of hours last night putting all this together. Obviously, both teams finished top of their group, Shipton winning four of their games, although I believe one was conceded. So, whereas Brackley won three, lost one. Brackley only got through on the head-to-head. They were joint points with Sanford St Martin, but Brackley won that game between those two. And about to hear 5-minute bell being rung as the teams make their way out onto the pitch for some photos, no doubt. So line up ahead of the minute silence.
Silence and the national anthem before we begin. The umpires for this morning's game, James Bartrip and Ray Manning. The scorers, Shipton scorer Sue Hayes, Brackley scorer Alex Blythe, and the scorers in the score box, Mick Warren and Joe Potter. Thank you very much to all the scorers. Thank you, Callum. I think Dean knows he's needed.
So the team's making their way out onto the pitch. Shipton currently at the bottom of the steps having a team photo. They're all in green with a bit of yellow and black on the shirts. Brackley all in blue.
The whole country, indeed the whole world, were very saddened at the death of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II after a reign of more than 70 years. We're going to hold a minute's silence on the bell, and after the minute's silence, there will be the singing of the national anthem. So this is in memory of Her late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. And the minute silence will commence on the ringing of the pavilion bell. Thank you. And are electing to bat first, opening the batting for Brackley are Eric Carpenter and Matthew Lowe.
Again, a very good morning to you all tuning into the live stream courtesy of Oxfordshire Cricket. Shipton fielders are all in place out on the field. We're just waiting for the Brackley batters to make their way down the steps and out onto the beautiful Wormsley pitch. I think we've got a couple of them ready. We're just still waiting. It is 10:30, so play is due to start any time. Everyone is in position except for the batters, which is slightly annoying. And here are the Brackley batters making their way down the steps. Eric Carpenter opening up with Matthew Lowe. Will be Eric Carpenter to face first. Callum Taylor, the opening bowler for Shipton.
Opening the bowling from the Deer Park end is Callum Taylor. Matt Carpenter, Eric Carpenter and Matt Lowe are opening the batting. The umpires are James Bartrip and Ray Manning. Enjoy the game.
As Kieran mentioned over the PA, we've got Callum Taylor opening from the Deer Park end. We've got the Deer Park end and the Dibley end here at Wormsley today. Taylor bowling right arm over. It will be Eric Carpenter to face, number 91 on his back. After a late cut, seems to keep a little bit low that one, first ball up, but play is now underway. And good morning again to you, Matt.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm skipping between doing the music and a bit of commentary, so the bulk of this will be done by Wes. He's an expert anyway, and I'm just a fill-in, so
You're multitasking today. Here's Taylor again, driven back down the ground by Carpenter, straight to mid off. Couple dots to start things first. Brackley electing to bat first, and a slightly green tinge to the wicket here at Wormsley today, and the sun is out. There's virtually no clouds at all in the sky, but it's quite chilly. Low ball toss that Carpenter's missed at a drive, straight through to the keeper.
Do you think one of the batsmen will have a go early doors? They normally try to, at least one of them.
I think so, yeah, especially after three dots. You think one of them, just having a little bit of a chat now in the middle. And 20 overs is longer than you think, but still after three dots, expecting big shot here from Carpenter. No, attempt to drive out into the covers. It could be a run out. Ooh.
I think if it hit, it was out.
I think so. It was, I suppose, after three dots, they felt like they had to do something, but
it was straight at the fielder, wasn't it?
Driven straight to extra cover. Not quite off the middle of the bat by Carpenter. As you say, a direct hit, and he was gone. We see the replay on the stream. And he would have been... would have been long gone, Carpenter. Don't want to be running the first over of a final.
Underarm throw. I guess that was definitely the right technique there from the way the ball was picked up. But it's not, I don't know, it's quite so accurate with an underarm through an overarm throw, because that's how they practice overarm mostly, isn't it?
And this is good stuff early from Callum Taylor. Just the one run off the five balls we've had so far. So one ball remaining in the over. Twenty-one games for Matthew Lowe over the course of the year. 150, best of 57.
Big swing there.
Big swing from Matthew Lowe. That's the end of the first over. A great one for Shipton. Brackley 1-0 after the first over.
A I've got plenty of boundary jingles lined up. Wes, I've got three sheets of them, so I'm expecting lots of boundaries today. I haven't had a chance to play one yet.
That's more sheets of music than I've got paper here. Time to find out who's bowling from the Dibley end for Shipton. We'll be carved to the face. Well, the keeper's standing up, so maybe a bit of spin, early doors, bit of medium pace. Got a slip in place. We've got a point cover, extra cover, short extra cover, actually. Mid-offs just hovering on the ring. Captain Rob Pansing just having a chat to his bowler at the moment.
Mills is bowling.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Opening the bowling from the is Sean Miller.
In case you couldn't quite hear that, we've got Sean Miller bowling from the Dibley end, a veteran of Shipton under Wychwood. Half appeal for LBW.
Too high.
Too high, you reckon? Miller, left arm off spin. Jack Leach-esque. In short run between the umpire and the stumps. Driven by Carpenter. That's a lovely shot. That'll be the first boundary of the day to Carpenter. A glorious on drive. And that moves to score to 5 for no wickets. 2 balls into the second over. That ball does seem quite quick. We had a bit of rain in these parts over the last week or so, but then what part of the country hasn't? It's been beautiful up until pretty much the first, second week of September. Right, no change in the field. There's a deep square out on the boundary. In comes Miller again. Drive from Carpenter, some slight inside edge of the bat, mid-wicket moves round to field. Good encouragement from the Shipton fielders. Slight change now, we've got D. Jarvis, I think that is, in a short mid-wicket. We've got another fielder slightly behind him. Slightly short from Miller and cut away by Carpenter. Slight misfield from, that's Freddie Norris there at point. Still no run though. 5 for no wickets. Last couple of balls of the second over. Tossed up this time by Miller and clipped out to slightly deeper of the two mid wickets. Well, this has been an excellent start by Shipton, considering they're put in the field. Shorter down the leg side. The first extra of the day, the first wide. They score to 6 without loss. Plays it off the back foot, does Carpenter. That will conclude the second over. 6 for no wicket, Shipton. Brackley, sorry, not Shipton. Shipton in the field. Well, after the toss, Shipton's captain Rob Pansing said they would have bowled first. Might be inclined to agree with him the way his team has started at the moment. Looks like it'll be Taylor to continue from the Deer Park end. The one slip in place, there's no point, there's a cover. Got an extra cover, mid-off, mid-on, just hovering on the ring. Got mid-wicket, square leg and deep fine leg. Sean Winner just making his way around to deep third man now. Square comes just behind the square. It's like a couple changes in the field now. Field has been moved around. Got the mid-wicket and square leg fielders now swapping positions. Here comes Taylor again. Driven out into the offside by Matthew Lowe. A slight misfield there at cover, and that allows them to come through for a fairly easy single. Takes the score to 7 for no wickets. playing a miss from Carmton. Another good ball from Callum Taylor. Stream's just a little bit behind on the photo. I can't see if that swung or not, or if Carmton played down the wrong line. Taylor, and again, fairly short run. Driven out into the offside by Carmeter, and it's missed the dive.
It goes through, that will be cut off.
Going to come back for a couple.
A little bit of a breeze now, Wes, isn't there? It's unfortunately causing a bit of shake on the camera.
Yeah, a bit of shake on the camera and some ruffling of the reams and reams of paper we've got to do. Down the wicket comes Carmeter. Oh, another quick single. Another good run by Brackley. Takes the score into double figures. Now 10 for no wicket. Some fairly risky running early doors by Brackley, would you say,
Matt? They got away with three there, I think, haven't they? Any direct hit and that was out.
And T20 have to take those risks. Shipton have got off to a good start. Driven out into the offside by Lowe, I think that is. Out to... Oh, I'm not quite sure where that went. I couldn't quite see it. Went straight to extra cover. Get signs of Lowe just wanting to free the arms. Either slightly more aggressive of these two batters. Another swing and a miss from Lowe. Well bowled from Callum Taylor. Maybe slightly slower. That's the end of the third over. Score is 10 for no wickets.
This is being streamed live on YouTube. And you can watch it any time.
Tossed up by Miller. Missed the dives of the short mid wicket. They could come back for two. And they will come back for two. Good fielding out in the deep, but quite a big playing surface out here at Wormsley. And another couple to Carpenter. Score moves to 12 for no wicket.
Very fast outfield here. There was quite a bit of dew this morning. They were using a special device on the back of the tractor to try and... And he's gone.
Really tossed up by Sean Miller. And Carpenter has to go. We're looking good for a moment there.
I'll play new batsman.
I'm going to been playing cricket for a long time, knows what he's doing. Carpenter has to go for six or seven, I think. We don't have the score to there with us.
LBW to Sean Miller. The incoming batsman for Brackley is Josh Markham.
Josh Markham, the new batter for Brackley. Four runs shy of 500 runs this season. A huge swing and a miss down the leg side. It will be given a wide. Loud appeal from Shipton's keeper, Jamie Nelson.
Zingers go mad.
I've got zinger bells. Didn't realise that today.
They got the zingers in. One of my favourite purchases of Oxford Downs Cricket Club, that is.
Fired in this time by Miller. Clipped out into the onside. Markham looking for a single. Almost comes halfway down the track. No response from Matthew Lowe at the other end. Good encouragement from Shipton fielders now. Strangling Brackley at the moment. And fired in by Miller. Slightly down the leg side. Oh, could be a run out here. And he's gone. Markham, the informed batter for Brackley. Run out, clipped it straight to fine leg. Both batters set off. A loud shout of no, and Markham is caught just short of his ground.
He was close, I think.
I think it was close. I don't think he quite got his bat down in time, did Markham? That is a big, big wicket for Shipton, one of the informed batters for Brackley this season.
Josh Markham run out, the fielder was Callum Taylor, and the incoming batsman for Brackley is the captain, Mikey Lowe.
Michael Lowe then, the captain, the new batter for Brackley. Brothers batting out together? Yeah, it is indeed.
Let's hope there's not a run out.
We'll see another run out then, yeah. 13 for 2 the score. Shout for LBW, first ball. If we for a couple of somethings, I think he's hit that. Didn't sound
I think
handy.
He hit it. Is there a signal here?
No signal from
yeah,
the
I
umpire.
Thought he hit it.
Couple runs for Monkey Lowe to get off the mark. 15 for 2.
I'm a long way off from here, so I shouldn't be able to say that, but it just sounded like he hit it.
It did sound more wooden than Paddy, that one. No forward in the fence again from Mikey Lowe. End of the fourth over from Shipton and Brackley. 15 for 2 after four overs.
The end of the fourth over, Brackley 15 for 2.
Looks like it will be Callum Taylor to bowl his third over of the day. We'll have one more left after this. Will be Matt Lowe to take strike. And still the slip in place. Shipton off to an excellent start here.
Keep the pressure on, isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. They said they wanted to bowl first. They lost the toss. They are bowling first. And they're finding themselves on top at the moment, it has to be said. 15 for 2, Brackley. Clipped into the leg side. Didn't sound quite off the middle of the bat from Matt Lowe, but that will race up towards the Thatch Pavilion here and into the pyrotechnics. Got to be careful there. The boundary for Matt Lowe takes the score on to 19 for 2. I believe that's Matt Lowe's first boundary as well. Driven caught at mid-off. Good catch. A straight term. And the third wicket now goes down for Brackley. And it's Matthew Lowe. He has to go for 5. Was looking to be a bit more aggressive. Just trying up that run rate. And Brackley losing 3 wickets in the power play. 19 for 3.
That's Matt Lowe caught by Aaron White off the bowling of Callum Taylor. And the score for Brackley is 19 for 3. And the incoming batsman for Brackley is George Brock.
George Brock then, the new batter. Two zeros on the back of his shirt. You don't see that too often. I want to make a bit of a statement then. 2-0. For his sake and for Brackley's sake, hopefully he gets more runs than on the back of his shirt.
Do you think that could be because his number's 100 and they just didn't have enough room to fit it on? I don't know.
This has been a really excellent start for Shipton. 3 wickets inside the power play. Taylor bowling really, really well. See a plane fly over in the distance. And virtually no clouds here at all today at Wormsley. Beautiful sunny day. Although the temperature wouldn't say so.
Yeah, it's a bit chilly, isn't it?
Almost played it, that one did. Right, left alone.
Do you think this bowler will bowl through, or?
I think with the way he started, I think Shipton would quite like to bowl him straight through. Just keep the pressure on Brackley and try and pick up as many wickets as they can inside the first six. And off the edge goes down to Gully. Yeah, excellent stuff from Callum Taylor. Just 10 wickets this season, at least on play cricket anyway. You might have more. Who knows with play cricket? It can be a minefield sometimes.
If he plays in the Cherwell League, it wouldn't be scored on play cricket.
Slightly shorter. Back goes Brock. Once again, goes out into the gully.
Yeah, that's unfortunately Nick, yeah.
So we understand the score isn't updating on the stream. Apologies for that. We're just going to find the gentleman who looks after the graphic overlays. And hopefully we'll get that sorted for you.
Left alone outside the off stump by Brock. And that's the end of an excellent over. Fifth over, as we said, from Callum Taylor. Brackley 19 for 3, having elected to bat, put themselves into bat. Need to start building a partnership, just rebuild. Just get to 10 overs, get to 12 overs, see where you are. Try not to lose another wicket. And then from there, try to accelerate. Miller continuing from the Dibley end. We are working on getting that scorecard fixed at the bottom of your screen. And it should be fixed now, so give it a second. Forward in the fence again comes Mikey Lowe.
Yeah, I think it's key they just don't lose another wicket here, even if they just go for 3 or 4 and over. Just keep the scoreboard ticking over. Just keep those wickets in hand.
Back goes Mikey Lowe, looking for a late cut, slight bottom edge. Fine leg moves around to field. They score to 20 now. And there we go. Scorecard is now working, so keep up to date. A little more breezy now. You might be able to hear in the microphones. Almost trying to blow the gazebo over here. Not ideal. Rock just taking guard, getting ready to face up to Miller for the first time. A few more people now sat around to our left. On the banking.
To kind of explain where we are based upon the camera angle you're looking at, we're to the left-hand side of the camera. We're on a raised verge. And I would say there's probably a couple of hundred people here already. Maybe more than that.
Tossed up by Miller and missed drive from Brock goes down to short through. They will come through for leg bite. Score moves to 21 for three. Again, really excellent stuff from Miller. Just the two runs off the server so far, I think. Just one of them off the bat as well. And just pushes that out to cover, does Mikey Lowe. End of the sixth over, end of the power play. So five fielders now allowed outside that 30-yard circle. And the score is 21 for three.
So that's the end of the power play. Brackley 21 for three. And Callum Taylor coming in to bowl his final over from the Deer Park.
And as we said, Matt, it will be Callum Taylor to bowl all four of his overs. And an excellent start for him. 1 for 9 off his three overs. Sean Miller, 1 for 10 off his three overs. 1 for 12, sorry. It really has been a superb start for Shipton, having lost the toss. Time to drive from Brock. We've seen quite a few play and misses so far.
It's difficult to tell from here, Wes. Do you think that's moving away?
I would say it's moving away, given Rock's left a couple and I've seen a few play and misses. It looked like Taylor is trying to shake things away from the right-hander. Still just the one fielder outside the 30-yard circle.
I think that's a good idea. Keep the pressure on, you know. Don't give them easy singles.
Oh, edge and gone. Brilliant catch from Nelson, the keeper. And the fourth wicket goes down for Brackley. George Brock has to go. And 21 for four. An excellent catch from Nelson. It's an unfortunate way to go, but we just look on the stream again. What a catch that was. Jamie Nelson diving in front of first slip to get low down to his right. And George Brock has to go.
So that's George Brock caught behind by Jamie Nelson off the bowling of Callum Taylor. And the incoming batsman for Brackley is Nathan Archer.
Nathan Archer, the new batter for Brackley, coming in under serious pressure in the final of the Wilf Bennett Trophy. Brackley 21 for four. Captain Mikey Lowe out there with him. Running through the scorecard quickly. Carpenter, LBW to Miller for 10. Matthew Lowe caught White, bowled Taylor for 5. Markham run out Nelson and Taylor for a duck. Mikey Lowe not out for 8. Brock just caught behind for a duck as well. And Nathan Archer now out there, ready to face his first ball. Left-handed bat, the first left-hander we've seen today. Taylor over the wicket. And to drive from Archer, almost snuck through onto the bat of Archer. Yeah, really excellent stuff from Callum Taylor. 2 for 9 he's picked up inside four overs of bowling. Oh, driven well by Archer, but straight to the fielder at mid-off. And Shipton really keeping the pressure on Brackley here. They need a release, but they can't afford to. 4 wickets down inside 6 overs. I bowled him!
Oh dear.
The stump goes flying back And Archer now goes also for a duck. And Brackley, five down after seven overs of play, having won the toss, chosen to bat first. And it's not paying off for them at the moment. 21 for five.
Nathan Archer bowled for naught, and the incoming batsman for Brackley is Joshua Rowland.
Josh Rowland, then the new batter. Looks like Sean Miller's going to continue here. Or is he? I don't think he is. We are going to have the first change of bowling from the Dibley end.
The Dibley end. Why is it called the Dibley End?
I haven't got a clue. It's not Scooby. Callum Taylor, four overs, one maiden, three for nine.
Change of bowling at the Dibley End. The wonderfully named Dibley End is Aaron White.
It will be Aaron White to bowl from the Dibley End. Going to see some right arm over pace as a change to left arm round finger spin. White, 15 wickets so far this season.
Is that a double wicket made in that last over?
Looks it was like indeed, it. Actually. Yes, it was. See another plane fly over us. All ball to start with for White.
So Callum Taylor's final figures, four overs, three for nine. Four overs, three for nine.
Slightly wider that time from White. Slow trying to get his bat down on it, run it down to third where there is no fielder. There's no one behind square on the offside. Point cover, so quite a straight extra cover, mid off, mid on. Two fielders out on the leg side, three on the leg side, sorry. And to clip into the leg side, appeal for caught behind. And wide signaled, so came off nothing at all.
Did sound like it hit him. I think it must have been his bat hitting the floor.
Bat hitting the floor, yeah. Or hitting pad, or there was a definite noise. But the umpire, very much not interested in that appeal. An attempt to cut, and yeah, another wide this time on the offside from White.
I think he was a bit lucky to get away with the first one.
It was a good take from Nelson for that leg side wide, diving full strength to his leg. He's kept well so far as Nelson. Slower ball this time from White, punched out to extra cover. And although they have had a couple wides, no runs off the bat so far this over. 23 for five.
Wide offside out, off stump again there. A little dibble at it.
A dibbly at it from the dibbly end. Short one, that's hit low. He's not played a shot, so I'm wondering what the umpires are going to do here. Are they going to give that leg bias? No, it's come off his glove.
I think it came off his glove.
Run from it. Yeah. Not play that too well from low. I wonder if that ball's just swung into him. The way we're shaping up the play, we're shaping to play that through the offside.
Yeah.
And it's come back in and
jagged back a bit.
Him on the gloves, yeah. Josh Rowland then facing his first ball. ball down the leg side, has dug that out or come off his foot or something. Fine leg's running round to catch it off and has done so. Good diving stop.
Superbly cut off.
For a couple of runs, a couple of leg byes.
When it first ran away, I was backing the ball there, but he got round tremendously to cut it off and made sure his training legs didn't hit the rope.
End of the over as well, so 26 for 5 at the end of 8 overs. Captain Michael O, 3 off 6, rolling yet to get off the mark. We'll have a change of bowler from the Deer Park end, just try and figure out who it is.
So we understand the score's not updating again. I think the person pressed the button, but I don't know whether it needs to press another button to get it to continually refresh, so apologies for that. We will read out the score on regular intervals.
And a change of bowling at the Deer Park end is the Shipton captain, Rob Panting.
Rob Panting then from the Deer Park end, captain of the Shipton side. Loud shout for LBW, not given. Low had a slight wander there outside of his crease.
And I know we're a long way away, it just looked too high to me.
No, there was something not quite right about it. It's got an interesting run up as Panting.
Kind of flicks the ball over at the.
He's got quite a jump when he comes into the crease. There we go. He's got an attempted ramp from Mikey Lowe. He's trying to invent something here. The pressure Brackley are under. 26 for 5. They need to try and make something happen, but also not be too risky. They don't want to lose too many more wickets, otherwise this could be all over quite quickly. Driven by Lowe. Good diving stop by the fielder at mid-off. Again, this is excellent, excellent stuff from Shipton. There's been a slight fumble or two in the field, but that's about it. So one catch coming to, then they've got a run out as well. Oh, could be another attempted run out here.
Buzzers, yeah, it would be a buzzer.
Overthrow. That's good awareness by the Brackley batters. Lowe just dropped his bat on the ball, run it out to sort of backward point. Threw at the stumps. I think the ball rebounded off the keeper and went out into the leg side. And good awareness from Josh Rowland to call Matt Lowe, Mikey Lowe, through for a single. Score moves to 26 for 5.
I guess it's a bit tricky for a direct hit run out once the stumps have already been broken, isn't it? Because you can only do it by pulling the stump out of the ground, isn't it?
To take a stump out.
So he was correct in going to the bowler's end, but there was never really a risk there. Always makes me think, what happens if all three stumps are out the ground? Do you have to put a stump back in?
Tempted cut by Rowland again. The ball just seems to keep a little bit low. If we go back to the last final this year, and being a Hampshire fan, I was delighted, but the way it ended was just
A bit farcical, yeah. Who knows what was going on? Everybody shrugging their shoulders.
Who pulled out what stump? Slightly shorter and cut away by Rowland, but straight to the fielder at point. Another dot ball, excellent stuff from Shipton, end of the ninth over. That was just the one run off that as well. 27 for 5 after 9 overs. We have a change at the halfway point. Got some pyro. We need some more pyro here. It's quite chilly. Yeah.
You can't see them off camera. We've got 4 flame guns here, and Paul's a bit trigger happy, our flame guy. I think they're aware there's no boundaries at the moment.
White to continue from the Dibley end. Short and attempted cut by low, I think that is there. No wide given, though.
Yeah,
from the
must
umpire.
Have been just inside the tram lines there.
Did seem to be stretching quite away for that, did Mikey Lowe? Yeah, full on the pads, but slightly down the leg side. No appeal from anyone. Again, two dots to start the over. Great start from Aaron White. Brackley 27.5. What do you think Brackley are thinking at the moment, Matt?
Get to 100. It seems he has no idea.
From low off the inside edge.
He had no idea where that went. I think
square leg comes racing in to pick up and through back into Nelson behind the stumps. 28 for 5.
100 does seem quite a long way off at the moment.
A very long way, but they just need to just try and get to 50. I think it's got to be your first marker. Try and get to 50 after 12, 13 overs, and then, I mean, who knows? The way Brackley have batted so far, 100 could well be a defendable total. Slightly shorter and cuts away, and that will race away for 4, and we are going to have a boundary. So warm the flames up. There we go. It's jumped up onto the grass berm. Another 4 for Brackley takes them to 32 for 5. Rowling gets off the mark as well. He moves to 4. Mikey Lowe on 6, not out after 18. And that's exactly what Brackley needed.
Yeah, I'm doing the music there, and the laptop had gone into power save mode. So
played. Oh.
I couldn't play a tune because by the time I got the laptop alive, the moment had gone. So apologies to the Brackley batsman there, not getting the boundary jingle.
Now got a deep third and a long on for Josh Rowland. Shorter just guided into the offside. This could race away for another boundary. Norwich is coming around and can't get there. No, back-to-back boundaries for Brackley and for Josh Rowland. Takes him on to 8. Brackley to 36 for 5 now. So pressure just easing off of Brackley for the moment. See a Spitfire fly over us.
They're really a Spitfire then.
I wonder if that's headed to London for Buckingham Palace. Most likely is. Queue's now over 25 hours, I've heard this morning, to see the Queen lying in state. Fuller this time from.
I think it's going to be a wide.
White and tend to swing down the leg side and. Will be given a wide, a slight fumble from Nelson. His one mistake so far today. Another couple runs to the Brackley total. 38 for 5.
He did quite well just to take the pace off the ball, so he didn't go for 5 wides, you know.
Yeah, there's no fine leg for Nelson. Attempted drive, attempted push into the offside from Michael Ogo. Straight through to Nelson. End of the 10th over, so we might have a slight changeover in just a minute. Brackley 38 for 5.
Overs gone. Brackley 38 for 5 off 10 overs. I'd just like to take this opportunity to thank our competition sponsors, Hartwells, who sponsor both the Wilf Bennett Trophy Final and the Oxfordshire Senior Final this afternoon between Horsepath and Banbury. If you're sitting at the pavilion side of the ground, if you look over to the other side of the ground upon a hill is a very fancy car, a Mustang of some description. So feel free to go over and have a quick look and find out how much it costs.
Too much. Panting to continue. Playing a miss from Josh Rowland. That one, again, just seems to be nipping away from the right-handers, whether it's swing or off the seam. Another good take from Nelson, though, behind the stumps. Slower ball that time from Panting, left alone by Rowland. I was hoping that was a wide, but umpire's arms firmly by his side. In other news, Kent Tarr 10 for 1 in the final of the Royal London Cup against Lancashire. Another dot ball from Panting. Excellent start from him. Three dots to start his over. Again, pressure on Ronan in these last three to try and make something happen. Punch off a back foot, but straight back to Panting. Excellent surf from the Shipton skipper. He's taken a best of 3 for 2 this year. Good economy as well, 3.78. One of the lowest in this game. Punched into the offside by Rowland. Just be a single out to the fielder at deep cover. 39 for 5 now. Ben Compton, the man out in the Royal London final. To drive by Michael Oak off the outside edge, goes down to deep third. Another run to the score though, takes load to 7, and the Brackley score moves to 40 for 5 after 11 overs.
So the end of the 11th over, Brackley 40 for 5. Some more thank yous for you. A big thank you to Hobbs Repro Graphics for producing the fantastic match day brochure. And also the brochures for this evening's Pathway Awards, which is the Oxfordshire Youth Pathway Awards, a culmination of 1,000 plus Pathway players that came through the Pathway this year, 290 of whom were selected for Oxfordshire and represented Oxfordshire across the age group. So a big, big thank you to Hobbs Repro Graphics. If you want a brochure or programme, they are available in the pavilion.
So I can have a bowling change from the Dibley end. Sean Miller back into the attack. Punched off the back foot by Lowe.
And James bowling at the WM is Sean Miller.
Miller into his last over. Bowled three tidy overs to start with earlier on. 1 for 11 his figures so far. Really tossed up by Miller. Slower ball. Stinked around the corner. Come through for a single. 41 for 5. I think things are ever so slightly starting to warm up, but I can feel a bit more heat from somewhere.
Oh,
could be another run out, should be another run out, and he's gone. That's twice that's happened to Brackley now. Ronan clipped it behind square on the leg side. It was Lowe's call. Thank you to Colin, who's put his jacket over me. And Brackley, 41 for 6.
So that's Josh Rowland run out. For 8, Brackley 41 for 6, and the incoming batsman for Brackley is Henry Whitehouse.
Henry Whitehouse then, the new batter. 384 runs, average of 32 this season. A couple of 50s in there as well. Slightly shorter this time from Miller, attempted to work that into the onside. Just comes off the pad. Shorter for Miller again, and again, just balls just seeming to keep a little bit low here at Wormsley. Attempted pull from Whitehouse, but probably hit him round about the knee roll or lower, I reckon. Short again from Miller, another attempted pull from Whitehouse. End of the 12th over.
Just doesn't look easy conditions out there, does it, Wes, at all? No, it dew on the pitch. This morning there was a real heavy dew. Yeah, cold.
Lowe's still there, though, the captain. 8 not out, 22 balls. He's actually third top scorer. Carpenter with 10, first of all. Then Roland just run out for 9. And Lowe's next best on 8, but it doesn't look easy to bat out there. Painting to continue. Tend to ramp from low. There's an appeal from the keeper. Going down the leg side, I think. Short fine leg moves around the field. Another leg by. 42 for 6.
To be fair, it could be because Shipton's bowled very well. That's the other.
That is very true. They've bowled quite well.
Should give credit where credit's due, you know.
They've bowled well. They've fielded well. Again, those run-outs, perhaps the result of just how good Shipton have bowled. Brackley feeling they need to go for runs where perhaps there isn't. Attempt to cut from Whitehouse. Another good take from Nelson behind the six. He's kept very, very well today. Good stuff from Panty. He's 0 for 3 into his third over. Two fielders out on the leg side, 3 out on the offside. That's a big heave into the leg side by Whitehouse. They've all dropped short of deep mid wicket. Just come through for the single. So Whitehouse off the mark.
Sensible not to go for the second there. Don't think there was ever a second run.
Absolutely, yeah. I don't want another run out.
No.
Frankly. You don't want two run outs, let alone three. 43 for 6 now the score. And same field for Michael O. Will he try and get the ramp out again? Slap back down the ground into, is it into the gap? No, well fielded out there by deep mid wicket. Again, keeps it to just two. Chipson's fielding has been excellent so far today.
Bounced just in front of him really awkwardly. He managed to get his hands to palm it down. Stop it going underneath his legs.
Another player miss from Whitehouse. And apologies for the scorecard. It's being a bit slow today. And instead of ball by ball, it's at the end of every over. So we'll try and keep reading out the score. Just to keep you updated. Panting in again. And a big heave from Whitehouse has gone straight up in the air. Is it going to be caught? It's dropped, unfortunately, by the fielder at Long On. Had to come in a long way to get that. It was almost landing in no man's land there. It was a good effort.
I think he misjudged it in the air because he ran forward. And if he carried on at the same pace, he would have got there in plenty of time. But then he was rushed at the end and it was, you know, in front of him, which is always very difficult diving forward.
So I've been praising Shipton for how well they've done. Unfortunately, a drop catch, but it's the end of the 13th over. 46 for 6 is the score. Mikey Lowe on 9. Henry Whitehouse on 3.
13 overs. Braffy 46 for 6. And a change of bowling at the Dibley end. Coming on to bowl is Ewan Roberts.
Ewan Roberts from the Dibley end. Young bowler, only about 18, 19 years of age, but quite quick. Nelson stood quite far back, probably about 15 yards behind the stumps. Yeah, well, deep fine leg, deep third, deep points for Roberts. Got a deep square leg as well. Everyone else inside the circle. Tend to pull from low, and they're going to come through for a bye. Good running from Whitehouse. Slight fumble from Nelson. And we'll be given wides as well. So another couple runs to Brackley's total. 48 for 6. Just trying to keep warm here in the commentary tent. Short ball from Roberts. No ball called. So
Free hit. Run to the total and a free hit as well. So
I'll get my jingle ready.
Wind those arms up, Henry Whitehouse.
We'll wait until after this one.
And then can't change the field. What do you think Roberts will do? Full outside off has got to be the best bet, surely. Don't want another run out off the free here. Here we go. The club into the leg side. Doesn't get hold of it. Goes out to mid on. I'll go through for a single. That brings up the 50 for Brackley. 50 for six in the 14th over.
So that brings up the 50 for Brackley. 50 for six in the 14th over. 50 for six.
Takes Whitehouse on to nine. Captain Mikey Lowe back on strike. Short and cut away by Low, well fielded down at deep third. Another run to the total. Takes Low into double figures. Makes him joint top scorer. Brackley Muter 51 for six. Thrawtron just dinked into the leg side by Whitehouse. Trying to keep track of the batters now. And a decent start from Roberts. Slightly quicker than the other Shipton bowlers have seen so far today. Thrawtron cut into the offside. It won't reach the fielder out there on the point boundary. They'll come through for a single. Slight fumble. They do look for the second, but it isn't there. And some good backing up by, I think that's D. Jarvis. In there at square leg. Another run to the score, 52 for six. Whitehouse moves to five. And you have to think, Brackley have to get at least 100, if not 120.
They're really going to have to go some to get to 120.
Got to try and get to a runner ball at least, you think, but... And again, we haven't seen Shipton bat on it. We don't really know what the pitch is doing too much. It does look quite green. A few have kept low. As I said, Shipton have bowled excellently here at Wimsley this morning. Short ball and pulled away. There's a fielder out at deep square. Lands just short. Does manage to pick it up, though. I'll have a run to the score. Low moves to 11.
It was a difficult chance. I don't think, you know, it's hit hard and pretty flat. He was having to dive forward. I think his first thought was obviously don't let it go through for four, because if you don't get anything on it, it would have been four.
And pulled away out to that deep square leg fielder again. Ross Barrett, that is. Does really well. They'll come through for a couple.
Oh, good arm.
Could there be another run out? No, it's not the best of throws, but... A good arm from Barrett, another couple runs to the score, 55 for six. Whitehouse moves on to seven, and that's the end of the 14th over as well. 55 for six, Brackley.
That's the end of the 14th over, Brackley, 55 for six. It looks like Rob Panting will continue from the Deer Park end. If you're feeling a bit hungry, a bit peckish, there's a barbecue being provided behind the pavilion, very reasonable prices, and that's part of the Old Coach Inn, one of our supporters. So please do visit and get yourself something to eat and a drink from the Old Coach Inn.
Captain Panting then to continue from the Deer Park end. Shorter and nudged into the onside by Lowe. I was looking for a single there. Almost got it in the gap, but quite close fielder at sort of mid wicket, mid on. Well, Lowe gets the ramp out, gets something on it, or the keeper's missed it. Goes down to deep third. They'll go through four. I think it's a bye. Yeah,
it's a bye, yeah. Didn't hear any noise as it went past him.
56 to 6. Apologies for the graphics issues on the screen. We'll try and keep you updated as much as we can.
Are they updating at the end of every over? I can't actually see what they're... I, They're completely stopped, have they?
Another play and a miss from Whitehouse. Seen plenty of those outside the off stump so far this morning. Another good take from Nelson. And guided out down to deep third by Whitehouse. Just be a single. 57 for six. Whitehouse on to eight. Clips into the leg side. That's gone down to the vacant final region. Jarvis is coming round to pick it up. He can't get there. And another boundary to Brackley. Takes the score to 61 for 6. And Mikey Lowe, the captain, moves to 15 as well. That's exactly what Brackley need at the moment. Even if it's just a boundary and over at this stage. To try and get through the next couple of overs. These two in. Low full toss and punched back down the ground by Lowe. Mid-off comes around to do the field. Another run to the total. Lowe to 16, Brackley to 62 for 6. And that's the end of the 15th over as well. 62 for 6.
That's the end of the 15th over. Brackley moved on to 62 for 6. More thank yous for you. Thank you very much to the Oxfordshire ACO for providing the match officials today. And a big thank you to some more of our sponsors, AVSL Security, our principal sponsors, Chadlington Breweries and Sirius Cricket.
Roberts to continue. Huge swing by Low, I think that is there, outside the off stump. If you got hold of that, that would have been on its way to Oxfordshire, perhaps even further. Roberts, 9 runs off his first over. Short ball by Roberts and wide signaled, another attempted ramp by Lowe. I don't think he actually got hold of one of those ramps yet. Yeah, there is still time. Another run to the total, 63 for 6. 2 balls into the 16th over. Got no one out on the boundary, down the ground. 4 ball from Roberts, inside edge from Lowe. The ball goes down to fine leg. They'll go through for a single. An excellent fielding by the fine leg fielder to sprint in, pick that ball up and make sure Brackley can't come through for a second. 64 for 6, Lowe on to 17. And fielders out on the boundary. Got deep square, fine leg, deep third, deep point. Short ball cuts into the offside again. Won't reach the fielder down there at deep third. And they think about coming for a second. Take a few steps down. Side against it. Freddie Norwich, I think that is down there.
To warm up.
65 for 6. Whitehouse on to 9. Huge swing outside the off stump. Not quite out of the middle of Lowe's back. Goes out two, mid-off. Another run to the total. 66 for 6. Lowe to 18. As a breeze just picks up again now. Another glorious day here in the Buckinghamshire countryside. Trees all around us. Roberts into the bolt. Cut away into the offside. Point comes round to field. Just be a single. 67 for 6. Whitehouse also moves into double figures now. He's 10 not out. It looks like we've got about 3 sight screens at each end just to make sure the batter can see the pink ball we're playing with today. Short ball from Roberts. Pulled. He's got hold of that one. As low? Well, not quite. His ball's just slowing up But it does trickle over the boundary rope. Takes low into the 20s. He's 22 knots out. And Brackley move into the 70s. They're 71 for 6 after 16 overs. And Brackley winning the toss, choosing to bat first. Just quickly run you through the scorecard. Carpenter was LBW to Miller for 10. Matthew Lowe was caught, white, bowled Taylor for 5. Josh Markham was run out, Nelson and Taylor for naught. Michael Lowe still there, not out off eight on 18 off 34 balls. From 22 off 35 now, that should read.
Taking over the bowling from the Deer Park.
Brock caught, Nelson bowled Taylor for naught. Archer bowled Taylor for naught. Rowland run out Taylor, Nelson for 9. And Whitehouse there on 13, not out. And a change of ends for Aaron White. Started out at the Dibley end, now bowling from the Deer Park end. 4 overs to go. Nudged into the onside by Whitehouse. A good single.
Good running there. You know, as soon as it's come off the bat, a good clear call. And easily a run there.
Probably didn't even get off the square. I've got a deep backward square of Shipton, but full ball from White. Hoiked out into the onside by Lowe. Mid-on can't come around and pick it up cleanly. They all come through for a single. 73 for 6, low to 23. It's good stuff from Bracken now, picking up the singles where they can, and they have picked up the boundaries as well. Driven into the offside. Oh, there's a huge mix-up here.
A run out again.
And another run out is the skipper this time. Mikey Lowe, run out for 23. Shouts have come on Henry, calling him through for the single. But no response from Whitehouse, and that's the big wicket for Brackley gone. Mikey Lowe for 23. And the score now, 73 for 7.
Mikey Lowe, the captain, run out for 23, and coming into bat for Brackley is Josh Withers.
Josh Withers then, the new batter for Brackley. Whitehouse still on strike though, 73 for 7. Well, that's a full toss and that's hit. Whitehouse the thing, he's come on something and it races down to final boundary. It's 4 off the bat as well. Would it be given no ball as well? I don't think it was that high. So just the 4 runs to the score, 77 for 7. And Whitehouse to 15. Driven out into the offside. Diving stop from extra cover. Maybe just got a hand on that. They will come through for a couple. Good running from Brackley. 79 for 7.
Was that a bump ball or was that a miscatch, do you think?
I think that was a bump ball. It was a good effort to try and stop the ball. And see the zing bells just fade away. 79 for 7. Quicker ball, it seemed, from wide. Inside edge onto pad as Nelson has to run down to find leg through the field. And they'll come through for a couple runs. And that could have been close again. But good running between Withers and Whitehouse. End of the 17th over, 81 for 7.
Over Brackley, 81 for 7. 81 for 7.
Whitehouse 19 off 21. So we have new bowler from the Dibley end. It'll be D. Jarvis.
And the new bowler from the Dibley end, the man who very proudly told me he played here before with Brian Lara. He's 11. This is D. Jarvis.
Keeper with the helmet on, he's going to stand up to Jarvis. Just trying to wonder what he bowls, because played with him a fair few times. Looks like he's going to be bowling, I think, leg spin. Judging by his action, got a deep cover out on the boundary. Long off, long on, deep square. Never known him to bowl spin before. He's always been quite a sharp fast bowler, actually. Tossed up by Jarvis. Loud shout for LBW, first ball and gone. Oh. With his go, his first ball to D. Jarvis's first ball, and Brackley are 8 down now, 81 for 8.
So that's Josh Withers, LBW to D. Jarvis, and the incoming batsman for Brackley is Rob Cartwright.
You okay?
So then Rob Cartwright, the new batter, will face up number 13 on his back.
Yeah, yeah.
Brackley 81 for 8. Number 1, the toss, chose to bat first. And D. Jarvis's leg's been picked up a wicket first ball. No change in the field for the new batter. And Nelson's just trying to help Cartwright take guard or something. Not quite sure what's happening between those two. Tossed up by Jarvis, and tempted to play that into the onside, did Cartwright, but
leading edge, I think there.
Leading edge, or maybe even back of the bat. Yeah. It was that early on it.
Desperate to get the bat on it.
Jarvis, yeah. Cartwright off the mark, first ball. Slapped back to the bowler by Whitehouse. Just trying to power it through. They need to try and get to at least three figures. Tossed up again by Jarvis. Huge swing by Whitehouse. Looking to hit that into the covers, I think. Just the other side of a raised berm to the right-hand side of your screen. And it's bowled in. Two wickets for Jarvis in his first over. And Whitehouse, the other set batter, is gone. Bowled for 19. And Brackley now 9 down, 82 for 9.
So that's Henry Whitehouse bowled by D. Jarvis. And the incoming batsman for Brackley is Douglas Smith.
So can Shipton finish the innings off in this over? Jarvis has got a ball or two left. And Douglas Smith, the new batter for Brackley. 28 runs, 19 games this season. How accurate that is, we're not entirely sure.
Yeah, because he would have been playing in the Cherwell League, and the Cherwell League tend to use TCS for their scoring packages. So
yeah, he might have missed a few stats out on these. But another left-hander. Jarvis, one ball left in the over. He goes for a big swing, does Siff, and I think that's a double. Oh, not quite a double hit made. There was a single off the second ball, but an excellent start for Jarvis. 2 for 1 off his first over, and it's the end of the 18th over, 82 for 9.
So two overs remaining. Brackley are 82 for 9. Two wickets for one run in that first over from Dee Jarvis. And bowling his final over from the Deer Park end is Aaron White.
White to bowl his final over then. 82 for 9 is the score. Two overs left, and even to get up to the 100, they need to go at 9 and over, which...
with no wickets in hand, it's a bit tricky.
Yeah, with one wicket left. Clipped into the leg side, and the umpire makes way for that one, and that should race towards us. Fielder's coming around, it doesn't quite pick it up from the boundary. And, well, I'm not sure that should be four, really. There's no signal from the umpire, but by my eyes, that
it's
very much a four.
It's
not great.
The fielder should say there, really.
Poor from whoever that fielder was. That should have been four, but it's just a single. 85 for 9.
Didn't they get two from that? They run two?
Well, they might have got three. It was three, it's an odd number because Smith is on strike. Cartwright onto four. Short ball down the leg side. An excellent take from Nelson.
Big wide.
It'll be a wide, so 86 for 9, but perhaps saved a fair few more, did Nelson there. He has kept really, really well today. Almost no mistakes. Can think of maybe a couple fumbles behind standing back to the quicker bowlers. Short ball again from White, just nudged into the offside, straight to fielder at short third, and they could look for a second here, but a couple of fielders converge on the ball, pick it up and keep it down to a single. 87 for 9. Douglas Smith off the mark.
So it's right in front of us there, Wes. I'm pretty certain it went across the rope. But
I'm extremely certain it went across the rope. Might have to remind that fielder that we are streaming, we are on YouTube.
Going to be another wide again.
Down the leg side. Attempted flick from Cartwright. Score moves to 88 for 9. A couple fielders now out on the leg side. Deep square, deep mid wicket. Low full toss from White.
The very toe end of the bat from the noise there.
Very, very toey. That one from Cartwright.
Where the vibration comes up through the handle, through your arms.
Slightly shorter this time from White. Attempted cut from Cartwright, goes through to Nelson. I think the standing umpire might have thought that's over. He's waving to someone.
Did the umpire signal there? Was that a no ball?
I don't think so.
Some kind of signal.
There was something. He was waving at someone for some reason, unbeknownst to us. Deep square now coming inside the circle. And a huge swing from Cartwright, a half appeal from the polar White. But another dot ball, 88 for 9. Last ball of the over. Nudged into the offside. Good batting from Cartwright. He keeps the strike. The score moves to 89 for 9 as the priest picks up. Our pens and paper are flying all over the place.
So that's the end of the 19th over. We'll get Aaron White's figures for you.
Don't want his figures.
4 overs, 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 4 From the Dibley end will be Lee Jarvis.
Dee Jarvis then to bowl the final over of this Brackley innings here. It's a picturesque Wormsley, a few clouds making their way across the ground.
A bit of a chilly wind.
It's extremely chilly. You can tell it's September, can't you? After weeks and weeks of heat waves and what have you, it's as soon as it hits September, it's...
Yeah, we're not sat in the sun. We're undercover here, so...
Yeah, that gazebo is sort of sheltering us from the sun, which is good and bad. It's good that we can actually see what's going on, but at the same time, the heat wouldn't go amiss. It's like changing the field. Field wrap mid off is now moving round to cover now.
Just said that the time is up, so the field restrictions have changed, which means that there's needs to be an extra quarter in there.
Cartwright a couple steps down, just nudged this into the onside. Mid wicket picks up, and because you couldn't quite hear that over the PA, Shipton have been too slow bowling their over, so they can only have four fielders outside the circle now. Tossed up by Jarvis, slight top edge from Cartwright. This could be out, should be out, and is taken by Vidon and Brackley. 89 all out in the Wilf Bennett Trophy final. They chose to bat first, and D Jarvis picks up 3 for 1 in 1.2 overs.
No maidens, no okay, thanks for
bowling figures as well.
Yeah, good one then.
Callum Taylor, 4 overs, 1 maiden, 3 wickets for 9. Sean Miller, 4 overs, no maidens, 1 for 12. Aaron White, 4 overs, no maidens, 0 for 31. Robert Panting, 4 overs, no maidens, 0 for 13. Ewan Roberts, 2 overs, no maidens, 0 for 18. And D Jarvis, 1.2 overs, no maidens, 3 wickets for just the 1 run.
Okay, Wes, that's great. You've got to go off to the car, I think, and probably get slightly warmer clothing. Okay, it's a fantastic day here. If you're watching us on the YouTube channel, then you're more than welcome. And that was a fairly good knock, but 89 all out. Probably below par for this ground. So we've got live streaming today, and we're very privileged to be here at Walmsley for these two T20 finals. You've just joined us, Brackley are 89 all out, and
while we're between innings, a reminder that both this morning's game and this afternoon's game are being streamed live on YouTube with commentary. Our commentary
team, you can probably hear the PA announcing that
Hospital Radio Turwell, Matthew Bowden and Wesley Spearman. Matthew's multitasking, he's also on the music. And Paul Fowler is very kindly doing the pyrotechnics on a coolish day. It's quite nice when the boundaries are hit because we get a bit of a warm-up. So that's always pleasant. We're going to restart the second innings at 1:05. So there's a little bit of time for you to perhaps go and get yourself a burger or a bacon roll from the old coach inn. There's a barbecue just behind the pavilion to the right-hand side. The old coach inn, and massive thank you to them and to Tim Howard for their continued support. I can heartily recommend the burgers and the food. Very, very nice. And if you go over there, they will look after you. And yep, there's plenty of refreshments at the old coach inn. Some more thank yous for you while we're waiting for the second innings. Again, a thank you to Hobbs Reaper Graphics. They produced the wonderful brochure, the programme for today, not only for the finals day, but also for this evening's Pathway Awards, which is the culmination of Oxfordshire youth cricket for the season. More than 1,000 players were involved in the pathway this year. Incredible numbers. 290 of those were selected for the various age groups across girls and boys cricket, from under 10s to under 18s. And a big thank you to all the coaches and all the volunteers, and also all the parents for ferrying their kids all around the country during the summer. It's been a hugely successful season again for the Oxfordshire pathway. And some real bright talent coming through, and the Pathway Awards get underway this evening at the conclusion, and the Pathway Awards will commence around about 6 o'clock, and you're all very welcome to stay and watch the Pathway Awards going on, and hopefully applaud and clap some of the talented youngsters that we have coming through the pathway. At 2 o'clock, in the tent, the marquee, it's the Grassroots Awards. Now, the Grassroots Awards that we're going to have around about 100 people attending, and that's the awards for all the wonderful volunteers around Oxfordshire over the last year. All the nominations are in the programme. And the grassroots awards are really, really special because cricket at this level wouldn't be going ahead without all the wonderful volunteers up and down Oxfordshire and indeed around the country. But we're going to recognise all the grassroots award winners today, even those that don't get the nod are here to be recognised, because it really, as I say, cricket wouldn't be the same without the volunteers at all these clubs. A few more thank yous. Another thank you to the Oxfordshire branch of the ECB ACO, the Match Officials Association, for providing the umpires today. And we'd like to mention our sponsors again, AVSL Security, thank you for your support. And also our principal sponsors, Chadlington Brewers and Sirius Cricket. Without your support, Oxfordshire Cricket wouldn't be able to put on magnificent shows such as this. And we are very, very grateful for Chadlington Brewers, who've been sponsoring us for a good few years now, and to Sirius Cricket, they provide all the kits. And they are, again, a big thank you to both of those. They're very big supporters of Oxfordshire Cricket. Just a final thing for now, before I hand over for a little bit of music for a few moments. In your brochures today, there's a page regarding the State School and Player Bursaries Fund. And we would be really grateful to anybody that's in the ground to have a look at that page. There's a QR code, and if anybody is able to make a small financial donation towards the State School Fund, this will enable Oxfordshire Cricket to deliver programmes to help bridge the opportunity gap between independent and state sectors. You can make a donation online, or you can go to the programme, scan the QR code, and it will take you to all the details. Or you can contact the Oxfordshire Cricket Performance Director, Matthew Barnes, all the details in the programme. And any donations in these difficult times will be very gratefully received. Thank you.
Welcome back to Wormsley for live coverage of the Oxfordshire T20 finals day. Got the Wilf Bennett Trophy final between Brackley and Shipton under Wychwood. Brackley made 89 all out in their first innings after winning the toss and choosing to bat first. And here comes the first over of Shipton's reply. Playing a miss. First ball from Jarvis. D. Jarvis on strike. Tim Senior out there with him. Josh Rowland opening the bowling for Brackley. Jarvis clipping that into the onside. Decent start from Rowland. These first couple of balls from the Dibley end. Defended by Jarvis. It's a good start from Brackley. I've got Matt Bowden joining us again.
It gave me a bit of time to warm up there, that break, thankfully.
Short ball cut away by Jarvis. That's his first run and Shipton's first run.
Nice shot, that.
Good shot. Just using the pace of Rowland.
Fielder now comes up inside the circle.
Got the one slip in play, short third. Point inside the circle. Got deep cover out just in front of us on the boundary. Mid off, mid on. A long off as well.
You're obviously expecting him to strike it down the pitch.
Senior back in defence for that one, but we have seen in the first inning is that a few of the balls are keeping low, so I'm going to try and get on that front foot as much as possible. Yeah, and back again goes Senior, punched into the offside. Cartwright does the fielding, and that's the end of the first over. One without loss, Shipton.
Very, very similar start, I think, to
I believe it was,
Brackley.
Yeah.
Had an excellent chicken burger, a piri piri chicken. It's one of those kind of burgers where I wish I'd had two. That would be too greedy, but
I might have to get one after this innings. I've got a cold bacon sandwich that I made this morning.
Cold bacon sandwich.
Well, it's cold now.
Oh, okay,
it wasn't
yeah.
8 o'clock okay. This morning.
And the bowler from the Deer Park end is Douglas Smith.
Douglas Smith and the bowler from the Deer Park end to open things up for Brackley.
Looks like they're starting seam from both ends here.
Yeah, so slightly different tactics early on. Shipton going to Sean Miller for some left arm spin early on. Tend to drive from Jarvis, punched out into the offside. Over through four, another single. Takes the score to two without loss.
Purely from a neutral point of view here, it would be nice to have a few early wickets. I think if these two get set, obviously, it would be very tough for Brackley.
Yeah, if Brackley can sneak three, maybe even four wickets in the power play like Shipton did, then could be in for a close game. Shorter for
that was a good stop.
Smith punched off the back foot, and as you say, Matt, an excellent stop down there in the gully. Saved at least a couple runs, if not four of them.
Yeah, speed of the outfield, that was almost certainly four if he hadn't got a hand to it.
Worked into the onside by Senior. Withers does the fielding at mid-wicket. And same field as per the last over. We've got a deep cover out on the boundary and a long off. Everyone else inside the circle. Shorter and guided down
that will
to
be four runs.
Deep third boundary. And the first boundary of the Shipton innings takes the score to 6 for no wickets. And takes Tim Senior off the mark as well. In defence goes Senior, ball goes out to point. Another dot ball, still a good start from Brackley. A fairly similar start, just that Shipton haven't yet lost a wicket, whereas I think Brackley maybe had by this stage, only over and a half in. Full ball from Smith aims a flick back at the polar stumps, but Jarvis well inside his crease, end of the second over. And Shipton are 6 without loss.
So at the end of the second over, Shipton 6 without loss. 6 without loss.
Like it's going to be rolling to continue from the Dibley end. A couple of people making their way behind the sight screen. Jarvis to take strike, not quite sure of his attire today, white pads but a coloured kit. Slower ball and got something on it, did Jarvis. Fine legs running back to cut it off. They'll come through for a couple. Will it be leg byes or is it off the bat? Have to wait for the signal from the umpire. And there is no signal, so a bit of glove in that perhaps. Takes Jarvis to 4, the score moves to 8 for no wicket.
Quite often you see them with covers for the white pads, a set of stretchy covers. It's quite an expense to buy a separate coloured pair
of
pads.
If you look at Senior at the other end, he's got black pads, I think. Attempted cut by Jarvis, can't quite get bat on it.
I'd be tempted just to get another white pair and use a black permanent marker.
Just colour them in. I'd make LBWs a lot easier as well. You can tell where the ball hit.
Yeah.
Take some of the marker off. Down the wicket comes Jarvis. He's not got hold of this. Mid on. He's running back and takes. Oh, no, he doesn't. Drops it. A couple of chances at it.
I thought he had that.
I think that is at mid on. Yeah, as you said, Matt, 40 had that. Not quite out of the middle of the bat from Jarvis, slightly top edgy.
And the fielder caught it, juggled it, dropped it. Was over his shoulder.
Forward in the fence this time for Jarvis. Midwicket comes round to do the fielding.
It always tends to calm a batsman down a little bit once they do survive the drop. I just think they then have a couple more watchful balls before having a go at the ball again.
Forward end again, defence again for Jarvis. Cartwright comes around, picks up, throws back to captain Mikey Light. And a decent crowd over to our left. Most of the seats and tables already taken up. In defence again is Jarvis. Ball runs out to Cartwright to backward point. End of the third over. Shipton 10 for no wickets in pursuit of 90. Earlier bowled Brackley out for just 89. Captain Mikey Lowe top scoring with 23.
It's one of those psychological things. You're chasing a low total, so you don't go along at the pace that you might more naturally go along on a T20 game, which then does make the chase, I think, slightly more tricky. You think, oh, well, it's only 90. I can just dibble a few here and from the dibbly end, get a couple of runs each over. And then before you know it, it is up round 7, 8 and over. And it's hard to change gears.
Smith to continue from the Deer Park end. Attempted play at that did Senior. He wasn't quite sure whether to play or leave that one. Those roots of Carpenter behind the stumps for Brackley. Attempt to drive from Senior. Four ball this time from Smith. Senior, he just seems to be hanging back a little bit. He's waiting for that shorter ball. He's trying to power it through the offside. And still deep cover and long off. The only two fielders out outside the 30-yard circle inside this first six overs. Another play and a miss from...
It's good Senior. Over so far.
It's an excellent over from Smith. The ball must be doing something out there. We're square on, so whilst we've got a good view of the whole pitch, we can't quite tell how the ball is moving. So if you're in the comments on the Oxford Cricket YouTube channel, do let us know.
Another big swing.
Huge swing from Tim Senior. This is excellent pressure from Douglas Smith. Four dots off this over so far. Score stays 10 for no wicket. And I think back to the first innings, this is exactly how Shipton started, just dotting the balls up, putting the pressure on the batters.
They did lose regular wickets. So direct
hit. Oh, for a quick single. And that's well run by Jarvis and Senior. Set off straight away, no hesitation. And they make the single pretty easily in the end. It takes the score to 11 for no wicket.
And Paz lost his hat. Running in to reset the stumps. Zingers light up with the direct hit.
One ball remaining in this fourth over. Jarvis on six, not out. Senior on five. And the umpire jogs back to square leg, places his hat. Well, not yet. There we go. Last ball of Smith's over. Loud shout for LBW and not given by the umpire. Maybe a little bit leg side, judging on where Jarvis was aiming to play that. It was quite full.
Height was okay from here, but obviously we can't tell, you know, the line at all from here.
Well, I guess, as we said, we've this is pretty much square onto the wicket, so can't really judge the line of the ball, but it seemed to be slightly leg side. End of the fourth over, Shipton 11 for no wickets, in pursuit of 90 to win the Wilf Bennett Trophy. Later on today, we'll have commentary of Banbury against Horsepath in the final of the Hartwell Cup. Taking place from 2:30 this afternoon. Josh Ronan to continue from the Dibley end. Slightly slower ball there from Ronan. Seeing he was looking to punch it down the ground, but just dropped the bat on it. Good applause from Brock there at point, I think that is. Quicker this time from Roland. Shorter ball. Cut out into the offside by Senior. Again, Brock making a making a lot of noise there at point, and feel like they have to. They need to keep spirits up. Yes, they were bowled out for 89, but they've still got to believe that they can win this game. Swing and miss from Senior.
One of my favourite games. I obviously support Oxford Downs, and we played Horsepath last year. We got bowled out for 60 something. We managed to bowl them out for 30 something. So you always got to believe, and these low scoring games do make very exciting games sometimes. Every run is precious.
Short again from running, and excellent. It was half stop from Withers, I think that is, at mid wicket. Just parried it onto his teammate up mid on. It certainly saved a couple runs. Did Withers score, moves to 12.
I'm just going to pick up on your earlier comment, chaps, that a low target to chase, and they seem to be taking it quite slowly, don't they? I mean, for me, as a T20 game, this is quite a low run rate, isn't it?
It It's extremely low from telling what we'd have expected. Clip from Jarvis, beats the fielder at fine leg, and that'll go away for four. Takes Jarvis into double figures. The score moves to 10 for 16 for no wicket. Jarvis moves on to 10.
I think it's called commentator's curse. As soon as I say a low run weight, they
well done.
Smack onto the boundary.
We get warmed up a little bit with the flames anyway.
Well, we are, yes. If you just joined us, we are live at Walmsley, and we've got these marvellous sort of pyrotechnic things there. Whenever there's a boundary scored, it goes shooting in the air, but we're getting a bit cold here, so we quite like the idea of boundaries because we get a chance to warm our hands on the flames. Back to you guys.
And defended out into the offside by Jarvis, works it down to deep third. Probably was over the keeper's head and backed up well by Withers. Score moves to 17, Jarvis to 11, and end of the fifth over.
So that's the end of the fifth over. Shipton 17 without loss.
Looks like Smith to continue then from the Deer Park end. Got a few more people wandering around the ground to our left.
The big thing here is they just haven't lost a wicket, you know. Very watchful start.
Jarvis to face. Down the leg side, maybe off the pad, I think, but that'll race away down to the fine leg boundary for four leg byes. Score moves to 21 for no wickets. And as you said, Matt, the key here for Shipton is to just not lose any wickets, because as you saw in the first innings, if you lose one, then you could lose a couple fairly quickly. I don't think Brackley bowled too badly here. They bowled pretty well. Yes, we had a drop catch, but besides that, their fielding has been pretty good. Over toss again, and ball's going to race once more down to the boundary. Another four off the bat this time from Jarvis. Takes the score to 25 for no wicket. Jarvis himself moves on to 15.
Fat fingers hit the wrong
button. Tim Senior at the other end on six.
Yeah, with those two boundaries, you know, you can just sit back for a couple of overs and noodle it around for the odd run here and there. Just makes things very easy.
Because there's virtually no pressure on the Shipton bat. I mean, chasing 90 in 20 overs, I mean, a lot of teams could probably get that done in 10. Playing the miss from Jarvis. The ball, again, seemed to just shape away from the right-handers.
And we just had a tweet coming in to say the cameras are moving around a little bit, and someone said, are there earth tremors there at Walmsley? And Kieran's just tweeted back saying, no, we can confirm there are no earthquakes in Walmsley at the moment. It's just simply the wind moving the cameras about. It's very reassuring, Kieran. Thanks for that. Back to you guys.
Yeah, the breeze picking up. We might be able to hear the fluttering of our gazebo. Driven by Jarvis, but not off the middle of the bat. Cover comes round to do the fielding as we hear a helicopter fly right above us. The plane flying overhead, leaving those white end trails. Trees surrounding us here at Wimsey. I forgot how long the drive was from the gate to the actual ground this morning. Bowled him! Maybe round his legs from Jarvis, looking to play that into the leg side. And that's the first wicket for Brackley, a much needed wicket. And
Jarvis.
D. Jarvis is bowled for 15.
Bowled by Douglas Smith for 15.
So then Shipton lose their first wicket. 25 for one is the score in the sixth over, the last over of the power play.
And the incoming batsman for Shipton is Aaron White.
And Aaron White, the new batter for Shipton. Just didn't have the best day out with the ball, so I think he has a better day out with the bat. Yeah. Then White to face up to Smith. Just one ball left in the over and a much needed wicket for Brackley. But can they have a sort of period of play that Shipton had when Brackley were batting, taking a couple wickets? Last ball of the over. He's gone back to that as White, but guided it down to third. Fielder will cut it off. Or maybe not. Or just going over the boundary, or fielder in touch with the boundary. But White's off the mark first ball. Takes the score to 29 for one, and that is the end of the power play. Also some.
So that's the end of the power play. Shipton 29 for one. And the new bowler for Brackley from the Dibley end is Rob Cartwright.
So there we go, Rob Cartwright to bowl from the Dibley end, the first change of bowling for Brackley. And the first sign of spin into the attack. It's good to see that fielder signal a four compared to what we had earlier.
Yeah, I
don't want to dig into Shipton too much, but
yeah, it's a bit frustrating. He definitely knew it went over the boundary rope there, and he should signal quite simply.
Got long off, long on, deep mid wicket, deep square. Four fielders out. They can have another Brackley, but choosing not to. Down the wicket comes Senior, punches it back to the bowler. And they think they need to pick up another wicket or two fairly quickly, Brackley. Driven out into the offside, into the gap, might go all the way. Rowland does the fielding, throws back into the bowler. Another couple to the score, 31 for one. Take Senior on to eight. It's down. Could we have a run out? No, not quite. Good fielding from Fine Leg, and perhaps that's where Brackley made their mistakes in the first inning. Shipton were quite confident that there's a run there, whereas Brackley, we had two run outs in their innings where they just nudged it to short Fine Leg.
It's very similar field position, wasn't it? And throw in, but the batsman was already down the other end. I think there was a little bit of hesitation in the Shipton innings between the wickets, and that just cost them.
Yeah, two runouts happening in exactly the same fashion. Mm. And off the slow ball, a batter just nudged it behind the corner, straight to Fine Leg. But yeah, that hesitation is what cost them two wickets. Where Shipton, as we've just seen there, confident in their running. They know they're chasing a low total. They can afford to take those risks, but as we've just seen, is it as risky as we first thought? So down the leg side, should be given a wide by the umpire. They're going through for another single as well. So a couple of runs to the total, 34 for one.
It was deflected, though. Did it come off the keeper, I'm guessing, did it? Or do you think that was just...
Not sure. I think I heard a slight noise. Seen you looking to come down the track to Cartwright. He just manages to walk back and dink it into the offside. Tossed up by Cartwright. That slog sweat. There's a fielder out in the deep. Will it be taken? No, another drop by Brackley, and he's parried that ball a long way back into the field. So Disco Leg has got to run from one side of the fat scorer's box to the other. And another couple of runs for Shipton, 36 for two.
It was between the two fielders, and he did have to move a fair distance, so it wasn't an easy chance there, but he did get to it.
And the track continuing, that slaps
Beto, yeah.
Back past long on. And another boundary to Sini. He's looking good at the moment. He moves to 15. And the score moves to 40 for 1. End of the seventh over. Seven overs gone here in Shipton's reply to Brackley in the Wilf Bennett Trophy final. 40-1 in pursuit of just 90 runs. And we'll have Douglas Smith to bowl his fourth and final over from the Deer Park end. He's made a couple changes to the field. We've got Fino back, third man back as well. Deep cover, the three players out on the boundary. Well, there could be a runner. There's a slight miscommunication, but they come through safely. A slight fumble from the fielder at backward square.
I think he slipped. Stud's not gripping.
Another run to the total, though. The scoreboard at the far end hasn't updated yet. Driven back down
seems
the ground
to be
by
a
senior.
Warning of scoreboards not updating. Yes, they've sorted the technical issue with the graphics overlays. Did they use the famous turn it on and off? Yeah. Ah, excellent.
Always, never fails. That's what we do at Hampshire as well, works every time. Driven by senior, and that's actually taken middle stump out of the bowler's end. The umpire's done extremely well to not get hit by that, and I'd be a little bit annoyed if I was seeing it there, because it absolutely levered that back down the ground.
Let's hope the zingers are okay. He absolutely nailed that into them, didn't he?
It was well fielded by the stump there, because that saved Brackley at least a couple of runs, if not three. That was making its way to the side screens at the Deer Park end for four.
Could have been extra unlucky, and the bowler just get a little nudge onto it for a run out, because it's almost certainly a run out most times when that happens.
Driven, but off the edge of White. Goes down to Matt Lowe at deep third. Another run to the score, 43 for one. White moves to six.
I saw a game this season where there was actually two of those in one game. Very rare to see one in a season, let alone two in one game. Yeah, the second batsman was incredibly annoyed. But, you know.
He's made a bit of a mess of that. Has senior, I think, that is on strike. Shaped to play down the leg side, but then offered no shot at all to that one. And I wonder if that ball has swung away by quite a bit. We've seen a few player misses. We saw one earlier where one of the Brackley batters got hit. Punched down the ground by Senior, just lofted over the top and goes away to the deep wicket boundary for another four. Score moves to 47 for one. And Senior moves into the 20s. He's 20 not out of 26 balls. And Shipton, well, they're now over halfway to their total after just eight overs.
Eighth over, Shipton moved on to 47 for one. 47 for one.
Cartwright to continue from the Dibley end. His left arm finger spin round the wicket. Long off, just having a few warm-ups now. Tossed up by Cartwright. Punched out to Rowland. Cartwright going for 11 runs off his first over. Want to tidy that up if he can. Big swing from White. Good take from Carpenter behind the stumps. driven out to Rowland this time. Slightly more sensible shot this time from White. So although you're chasing 90 and you sort of want it to get it over and done with as soon as possible, you don't need to take too many risks. Clipped out into mid-wicket. You can start from Cartwright in these first three or four balls. Yet to go for a run this over. Slightly shorter this time and punched off the back foot. Good stuff from Cartwright, just putting a little bit of pressure back on Shipton at the moment. Shorter and punched into the offside, and that will go through for another boundary. Brings up the 50 as well for Shipton. Takes White into double figures. He moves to 10. That's the 50 effort. Josh Roden tries to avoid being hit by the flames. And the end of the ninth over as well. 51 for one. And we've got a change of bowling from the Deer Park end. Looks like it's going to be Mikey Lowe, the captain.
And a change of bowling at the Deer Park end. It's the Brackley captain, Mikey Lowe.
Another sign of spin from Brackley. Deep cover, long off, long on, deep in wickets, out on the boundary. Four fielders. Everyone else inside the circle. Got short fine leg, short third. Points, extra cover. Sort of a straight mid on as well. Chip back down the ground by Senior. Long off, long on, converge. Another run to the score. Senior to 21. Shipton to 52. Look down to short third this time by White as the scorers have decided to take his score down from 10 to 1. It's like malfunction in the old Thatch score box.
Ooh.
Is White just looking to play that into the offside? He's going back to a fairly full delivery from Mikey Lowe. A sweep out. He's gotten straight back down the ground. Long off does the fielding. Another run to White, takes him to 11. Shipped into 53. Just 37 more runs required off, potentially 10 and a bit over. They're well on their way to securing the Wilf Bennett Trophy. Tossed up by Mike Lowe. There's a fielder out in the deep. This should be taken and is taken. The captain gets the breakthrough for Brackley. And it's the big wicket of Tim Senior. Was looking good. 21. Relatively quick time as well compared to other innings we've seen today. But
Tim Senior caught Rowland off the bowling of Mikey Lowe.
Good breakthrough for Mikey Lowe. The chip to move to 53 for two. Jamie Nelson then, the new batter for Shipton. Coming in at 53 for two. His team well on his way to winning this game.
And the incoming batsman for Shipton is Jamie Nelson.
Batters did cross, so will be White on strike. He's 11 not out. Fired in by Mikey Lowe, good change of pace. That's the end of the 10th over. 53 for 2 at the halfway point.
The end of the 10th over then. Shipton 53 for 2. And at 10 overs, just a couple of thank yous and mentions. Another big thank you to our competition sponsors, Hartwells. who sponsor this competition. If you look over the far side of the ground, there's somebody sitting in the Mustang at the moment, so give us a wave. There you go. If you want to go over and have a look at that car, please do so, find out how much it's worth, see if you can afford it. Just another quick announcement before the next over starts. If anybody does require any first aid today, hopefully you won't, and hopefully Mandy will be redundant for the day, but if you need any first aid, if you come over to the pavilion, and Mandy will put you right.
Cartwright to continue from the Dibley end. Nelson to face his first ball, defends into the onside.
Just to go back to the batsman crossing there, Wes, when did the rules change in...
I believe it's fairly soon. I want to say, I think it's either just before or just after the T20 World Cup next month. Good diving stop by Rowland.
So those who don't know, the rule is changing now. So if the batsmen do even cross, you do still have the new batsman facing. That's right, isn't it, Wes?
Yeah, that's correct. It was sort of brought about by the 100, one of the new rules they brought in. And the ICC obviously like that and decided to keep it. And I think it's a good addition.
It's the right thing. You know, why shouldn't you have a go at the new?
Fired in slightly shorter from Cartwright.
So we've been informed it's the 1st of October that rule comes in.
So that should be the T20 World Cup should be the first competition to have that rule in, internationally anyway. Tossed up by Cartwright, a good diving field by
great
good
stop.
Wicket. And would have probably only saved one, but again, Brackley just needs to keep this pressure on Shipton. Try and force them into mistakes.
Oh,
driven back to the bowler again. Good over from Cartwright. Just the two runs from over from Rob Cartwright.
55 for 2 Shipton. A big thank you again to Hobbs Reaper Graphics for producing the programme today. And also there's a programme for this evening's Oxfordshire Youth Pathway Awards. A culmination of more than 1,000 youth cricketers through the pathway this year are being recognised this evening. 290 players represented Oxfordshire this year, and the Pathway Awards are this evening, starting around about 6 o'clock.
Mikey Lowe to continue. To drive from White. So that's a slight fumble from Carpenter. Shipton really don't need to take any risks at this point. Punched off the back foot into the offside. Deep cover picks up, does the fielding. Another run to the total. 56 for 2. White to 13. Nelson on strike for the first time to... Michael Owe tosses this one up and always stumped, I think he's given. Great hands from Carpenter. Good change of pace from Mikey Lowe as well. Really tossed that one up. Slowed it down. Enticed Nelson to just come out of his crease. It wasn't by that much. He didn't take steps down. Just stretching for it and quick hands by Carpenter and Nelson. Gone for a single. So chipped in 56
Nelson
for 3.
Stumped. By Carpenter off the bowling of Mikey Lowe, and the incoming batsman for Shipton is Freddie Norridge.
Freddie Norridge then, your new batter for Shipton, coming in at number 5. Attempted drive from Norridge. Edge of the bat, misses the hands of Carpenter. Carpenter Cartwright does the fielding. Too many old professions in the Brackley team. Driven out into the offside ball. Excellent diving stop by Withers at point, I think that is.
That's good over there.
And a good over from Brackley's captain, Mikey Lowe. Just the two runs off it and the wicket of Jamie Nelson for just a single. Shipton 57 for three, 12 overs gone. And it looks like it will be Rob Cartwright to bowl his final over from the Dibley end. Try and keep you updated on the score again. The graphics have just stopped. Driven by Norwich out to Matt Lowe at long off. Norwich off the mark, takes Shipton to 58 for three. Tossed up by Cartwright, just misses the dive of the bowler. Mikey Lowe at long on, does the fielding. Another run to the score, 59 for three. Tossed up again by Cartwright, and they're pushing for the two here, and they will get it. Good running from Shipton.
I think the fielder who picked that up has got something wrong with his arm, because he's thrown both in underarm there, so I'm only guessing he's, unless he always knew there was two. There's no point in wasting the arm, I don't know.
Sixty-one for three then, Shipton. Driven by Norwich out into the covers. Rowland does the fielding at extra cover. Toss up and driven through the gap in the covers by Norwich. Runs away to the boundary for four. Takes Shipton to 65 for three. And Norwich moves to eight. At the end of the 13th everywhere, there seem to be a lot of boundaries off the last ball of the over.
That's the end of the 13th over, Shipton 65 for three. And my math calculates that means they need 25 for victory.
That's awesome. Well done, Kieran. Kieran just pointing out they need 25 for victory there on the PA.
Mikey Lowe then to continue from the Deer Park end. It'll be Aaron White on strike. Feels like he hasn't faced a lot of the bowling recently. Guided that one out to short third. As we see some of the players in the second game turning up, bags on their backs. White cliffs this
good
one out.
Running here, direct hit. Oh, and it's going to be some buzzers.
Lucky, that's going to be an extra four. Off the bat of Norwich, and it's unfortunate. It's five runs for that one, takes Shipton to 70. And wow, just when you think things couldn't be going worse for Brackley, then that happens. Shipton now then, just 20 runs required for victory.
Done a bit of a Ben Stokes there.
Yeah, it's one of those annoying things in cricket where it so rarely happens, but you can't do anything about it. And you feel sorry as a batter. But rules are rules, I guess.
I think if it goes for a boundary, it's just one of those things. But
it's just one of those things.
The gentlemanly thing is not to run. So if it came off your bat, you shouldn't run another run.
Cliff clipped into the leg side by Norwich off the toe of the bat. Yeah, usually if it hits your bat or pad or just you yourself, then the thing is you don't run. But yeah, if it goes for a boundary, then there is nothing you can do about it.
Technically, in the laws of the game, if you were to run, the run would count, though, I think.
It would count, yeah. Yeah. It's just not the thing to do. It's the spirit of the game rather than a natural law of cricket. But another single off that final ball of Michael O's over. 71 for 3 is the score. End of 13 overs, I think, if the scoreboard... 14 overs is just updated. Aaron White, 19. Freddie Norwich on 9.
Obviously, if there was no deflection or deflection off of one of the fielding players, then it's perfectly legitimate to run. Yeah.
Or off the stump, as we saw earlier.
Oh, off the stump. Yeah, yeah. Looks like a coach has just turned up.
Yeah, there's a lot of players. Horsepath, I think that is, in their blue. Josh Markham then taking over from Cartwright at the Dibley end.
Tell the professional commentator here as he works out which player is who and their shirt numbers, he's writing them down.
But Markham, I didn't see his number when he came out to bat earlier. Annoyingly, Shipton don't have numbers on their bat, which is... Luckily, some of them have white pads, which makes it a little bit easier. Norwich on strike then. Markham to bowl his first over. Right arm over the wicket. Slightly quicker and back in defence goes Norwich. Certainly looks a bit sharper than the other bowlers we've seen today. Just 19 runs required for victory now for Shipton. Got a deep fine leg, deep third. Quite a squarish cover. Long off, the five fielders out on the boundary, plus a deep square leg. Short ball from Markham, a swing and a miss from Norwich, goes through to Carpenter behind the stumps.
Interesting, you didn't get the signal from the umpire to say that was two in an over, or is it one in an over?
I think it's one in an over, T20s. Driven out into the offside by Norwich. Not quite timed. Ronan picks up in front of us. Score moves to 72 for 3. Norwich into double figures. As we see Horsepath turn up. Looking to take the title from Banbury. They've won it, I think, the last few years of Banbury. Playing a miss from Aaron White. Not much footwork there. So he's beaten by the pace of Josh Markham. And slap that back down the ground has Aaron White. Just the one bounce to Matty Lowe at long off.
You see he threw that in underarm again there.
Yeah, just must be something wrong with
shoulder, right.
His arm or something.
This bubble now has got a bit of pace to him, so I wonder why he didn't play him on a bit earlier.
Driven out into the offside by Norwich. Rowland once again. Wheels round. Throws back into Carpenter. 74 for 3. And we've seen the slow bowlers be quite effective on this pitch. We saw Sean Miller bowl really well up front. Seen Mikey Lowe take a wicket or two.
That's what I'm right in saying. If you don't get your line and length right as a fast bowler, you just need to sort of more or less guide the ball, don't you? So
exactly,
let the ball do the work.
It's good that Brackley had those the fine leg and the deep third to protect for that exact shot. I mean, even if the keeper misses it, then... Good luck trying to chase it down.
Am I right in thinking that we've got a slope going up towards the thatched?
I believe so.
It does look like it. Anyway.
Swept by Norwich. Beats the dive of Brock, I think that is. And the ball is just edging its way across the boundary and it rolls over. Four more to Norwich, takes him to 15. And Shipton to 74 for three. Just 12 runs, they're two hits away from the Wilf Bennett Trophy. Fired in by Michael O, driven back down the ground. We'll get one. Can they come through for two? No, good fielding. Out there by the man at long on, George Brock, I think that is. Chipped back to the bowler by Aaron White. He's moved into the 20s now. Really tossed up by Michael Owen, slapped back to Brock at long off. Another run to the score, takes them to 80. White to 21, 10 to win. Kieran's maths are on point again. Clipped by Norwich out to long on this time. Another easy single for Shipton, 81 for three. Tossed up again by Michael Ope. Driven up down the ground to Brock once more. Another run to the total. Concludes the 16th over. And Shipton 82 for three. Eight runs required for victory. And there are five overs to do it.
Shipton 82 for three.
And Michael O finishes as well. Four overs, no maidens, 2 for 18.
Michael O's figures, 4 overs, 2 for 18. 4 overs, 2 for 18.
Markham then to continue from the Dibley end. White drives off the thick outside edge. The ball runs away down to deep third. And four more to the total. White moves to 26 and Shipton 86 for three there. Four runs away from the Wilf Bennett Trophy. And that's the downside of pace, Colin. Just an edge and
yeah, we've just been saying that. Man. And again.
Driven back down the ground out to mid on.
I was just saying, if you don't get your line and length right with a fast bowl, you've just got to really just sort of almost point it at the bat, haven't you, and edge it away. And the boundaries are quite quicker, aren't they?
Especially on an outfield like this, because the outfield has been absolutely rapid so far today, and I expect it's only going to get quicker with the sun out, baking the outfield. That's a full toss from Markham, just guided into the offside, and shy at the sense misses from Cartwright. Another run to the total, 87 for three, White to 27.
Just one hit now. Actually, it was one hit, one run ago as well. Yeah. Actually, it was one hit, 3 runs ago if you count sixes, but yeah, that's why you're the professional.
Norwich on strike then. Can he finish it this ball? Three runs to win. Hits him on the pad. Ball just trickles out into the leg side.
So wickets and overs to spare. Nice position to be in on a sunny day at Walmsley.
Oh, there's a slip from White, and that would have been out if that would have hit. Rowland, I think the...
Don't think it would have made
White
a lot of difference, you know.
At mid-wicket. Would have made much difference with just 3 runs required for victory for Shipton, but... It's just been a moral victory for Brackley, that one. White on 27. Mark and then into Norwich. Clips him down to deep fine leg. Come through for a single. Norwich to 18. Shipton to 88. And the end of the 17th over here in the Wilf Bennett Trophy final at Wormsley. Then 2 runs to win. How many balls do we reckon it'll take Shipton to finish off that? Looks like it's Nathan Archer to bowl from the Deer Park end. Will be Freddie Norridge to face Archer. All the field is up now with just two runs to win for Shipton. He guides it down to deep third. They'll get one. Will they come through for two? Carpenter is after it. He dives, he stops it. They come through for two.
Yeah,
and
well
that
done,
is victory
Shipton
for Shipton. They've won the Wilf Bennett Trophy by 7 wickets. With 2 overs and 5 balls to spare, it's been quite a complete victory. Bowling Brackley out for 89 and chasing it down with plenty of wickets and plenty of time to spare as well. Aaron White finishes 27 not out, Freddie Norridge 20 not out.
So congratulations to Shipton Under Wychwood Cricket Club, winners of the 2022 Wilf Bennett Trophy.
And a pretty complete performance and a fairly simple chase for Shipton in the end.
Congratulations to Brackley, many thanks, and congratulations actually to both sides for reaching the final here at Wormsley. And a big, big thank you to all the Wormsley staff and Wormsley Cricket for hosting today. Fantastic venue as always. Thank you so much to all of the ground staff and everybody for looking after us today. And on behalf of Oxfordshire Cricket and Brackley and Shipton, a massive, massive thank you. So Shipton Under Wychwood are the Wilf Bennett Trophy winners for 2022. Congratulations to Shipton.
So as the players make their way off the field, handshakes all round for the Shipton batters. Handshakes between the two teams as well. Just run you quickly through the scorecard. So Shipton 90 for 3, chasing that down in 17.1 overs. Dee Jarvis was bowled by Douglas Smith for 15. Tim Senior, Court Rowland bowled Mikey Lowe for 21. Aaron White remained 27 not out of 28 balls. Jamie Nelson was stumped Carpenter, bowled Mikey Lowe for 1. And Freddie Norridge 20 not out of 22 balls.
So as the players leave the field, bowling scorecard,
Josh Rowland, 3 overs, no maidens, 0 for 11. Douglas Smith, 4 overs, no maidens, 1 for 21. Rob Cartwright, 4 overs, no maidens, 0 for 25. Mikey Lowe, 4 overs, no maidens, 2 for 18. Josh Markham, 2 overs, no maidens, 0 for 9. And Nathan Archer, the 1 ball, 0 for 2. And Shipton are crowned winners of the Wilf Bennett Trophy.
So we've got some presentations to come up, which I think are some of the Pathway Awards. Kieran's gone off with the radio mic. We'll probably have another second mic to try and see if you can hear that through the PA. If you've had enough of us the time being, I wouldn't blame you. Then why don't you nip off and have a spot of lunch and come back, and we will be starting at 2:30 again for the second of these games this afternoon, which I've got my thing here is between, it's the Hartwell Oxfordshire Senior Cup between Horsepath and Banbury, second game today. That starts at 2:30. At 2:30, we will be joined by listeners to the Radio Child, which is the hospital radio network for Oxfordshire, and we'll be taking the live commentary right the way through until 5:30. During that game, we'll have live updates from the Kasam Stadium. Oxford United take on MK Dons this afternoon in the EFL League One match. This gives us a chance, really, for Wes Spearman and Matt Bound to go off and I think warm themselves up a little bit. It is the sun is shining here. If you're watching on the YouTube channel, you can see that actually it's a wonderful sunny day here, but there's a bit of a north wind here today, and the only bit of warmth we get is from the occasional cup of tea. And for the pyrotechnics, Wes, isn't it? That, which do, I mean, we're quite a way away from. They do let out a huge roar, and we do get a blast of warmth, don't they, coming towards us?
Yeah, I'll be hoping for a few more boundaries in the second game, because although they are a good 15, 20 metres away or so, they do feel the heat from quite some distance. And although this gazebo is handy and keeps us sheltered, but the sun's the
yeah, you could do with some sun today, couldn't you? Brackley did win the toss, decided to bat on a wicket that's got a little bit of green on it. You can see if you're watching now on the YouTube channel that they are mowing the little bit of grass that's on that wicket today. I've seen the short form where it's good to field first and then chase down a target. Is that right? That seems to be the way that things have gone. That 100, dare I mention, that's a shortest form of the game. Was that a poor decision today for Brackley to win the toss and put himself in the bat first?
Possibly. Well, in hindsight, I suppose, yeah, yes, it was. Right, but yeah. I think if you win the toss, you want to try and win the game. But certainly away, a lot of professional games are going. The sort of mantra is to bowl first. Yeah, especially on a wicket that is a little bit green, and as I've seen with some of the balls today, the ball was swinging around quite a bit, a few kept low, so maybe not the easiest pitch to bat on, but I mean, even so, winning the toss and batting first, you hope to get more than 89 all out. You want to at least go minimum a run a ball, try and get 120, push that up to 140, 150 if you can, but
yeah,
to be fair to Shipton, they did bowl really, really well up front, took those three quick wickets in the power play, maybe even four, I can't quite remember now. And that effectively killed the game before it barely even started, when Shipton were 20 for four or wherever they were. But
I think in the short form of the game, it seems to me that if you do set your stall out quickly, you preserve your wickets and score a good set of runs, then you're probably in pole position, aren't you? So I mean, they got to about 50 for one or 50 for two. There are odds on to actually do this. Right, we're waiting for the pathway awards to start. We do apologise for the wind noise on the mic. It is very, very blowy here despite the sunshine. And also we will stick a mic towards the PA system so you can hear what's going on. But if you do want to nip off, have some lunch, do that, and do come back and join us at 2:30 for the second of our T25s, which is the Hertfordshire Senior Cup between Hawthpath and Banbury. We'll go quiet now for a little bit, just to let you. It's not the test card, it's just actually, we call it the Walmsley card. A view of the pitch, as you can see the ground staff out there doing a superb job today. We'll be back with you with live commentary probably a little bit before 2:30, when we hope to be joined by Radio Channel listeners. But for myself, Colin Ryan, Wes Spearman, Matt Bowen and Kieran Bushnell, we'll say bye-bye for now, but you may all hear us break in with a bit of news from the various pathway awards, but for the time being, they'll bye for us now. Yeah. Thank you.
Right. You okay? Yeah. It's all right. Yeah.